Good morning, Wednesday, the 24th day of June, 2020. I'm Vincent J. Russo of the Russo Law Group. And today, I thought we would explore how to hire an attorney. And that could be difficult. It's hard to know if you're connecting to the right attorney who can really help you. So I'm going to have Kim Christian, my partner, join us and talk about the questions that you should be asking and the steps that you should be taking before you make that leap in hiring an attorney. Hello, Kim. It's great to have you back. You were with me last week.
Hi, I'm glad to be back.
So today, I want to tackle how do you select an attorney. Last week, we talked about what happens when you come in and do a planning meeting. So that's the big question. How do you do it?
Yeah. Selecting attorney actually is a really important process because you want to make sure the attorney has the experience and knowledge in the field of law that you're looking to accomplish your goals in. So I would say the first thing to do is to find out what kind of experience does this attorney have? How many years of practice have they been doing this? Is this a law firm that does multiple areas of practice, or do they focus in a specific area that meets your needs? What kind of publishings do they have? You can even look at testimonials and see some of the great work that they've done.
Yeah, so I guess checking out their website and all the information, the bio, and that's helpful. And also to get a feel for the whole firm, what's the culture of that firm? Am I going to be comfortable there? So let's say I do that, and then I say, well, maybe I do want to meet Kim Christian, but I'd like to talk to her first.
Yeah, I mean, that's really important. You should feel free to give that attorney a call. You know, request a phone call with them. Kind of get to know them, just even if it's a short verbal conversation. That attorney should be willing to schedule something with you just to do an introduction. Like, because as I said earlier, feeling comfortable is actually very important.
And so would you go and see that attorney if you call the office and they refuse to speak to you or even set up a time later on to speak to you?
Well, if there's a refusal to ever speak to me, whether it be now or later, I would not go to that attorney. I think it would speak to the availability of them. So I think that's a pretty good indicator.
And how do you feel about what we'll call qualified referrals? I know that can be very helpful. What is that?
Yeah, qualified referrals are actually very, very helpful. What they are is a referral from a professional that you're familiar with. So for example, if you had a certified financial planner, or you had an accountant, or you had someone in your professional circle that has referred you to your attorney, you could feel comfortable knowing that they've most likely had a lot of clients have a good experience with the attorney. Remember, they're on your team. So if they're referring you to a specific attorney, then they feel that that attorney has the knowledge and the experience to help you with your plan.
Yeah, I think that could be really helpful. And a qualified referral could be from a family member or a friend who's had a very good experience with another attorney who can help you.
Yeah, that's so true. A lot of times we think of, you know, professionals as qualified referrals, but often our loved ones, the people closest to you who want to steer you in the right direction, have the best referral information for you. And it's good to listen.
Absolutely. So I want to thank you for these tips on how to select an attorney. And Kim, have a great day too.
You too. Have a great day, everyone.
Well, I sure hope that the tips that Kim and I gave you this morning can really help you out when hiring an attorney. And it may also just come back down to trust, a matter of trust. Everybody have a great day and be safe.